So you have to do a PowerPoint presentation. The likelihood is that you know how to design it, but do you know how to present it? I've noticed that many PowerPoint novices don't know the difference between the edit and presentation modes, and that's a must. You also need to know how to get in and out of the PowerPoint presentation mode by using the various PowerPoint icons or keyboard shortcuts. And if you practice, there are some cool tips to bring your PowerPoint presentation skills up to the next level. Let's start with the mode you probably know the best, the edit mode, technically called the normal view. This is the mode you use when you are designing your slides. You know you are in the edit mode when you can see the slide you are working on in the center and all of the other slides in your presentation lined up on the far left of your screen. But you don't want to present in edit mode. That looks unprofessional. For that, you need to go to the presentation or slideshow mode, which is the view I'm in now. And there are a variety of ways to do it. Let me start by getting out of the presentation mode by pressing the escape key. Now you can see that I'm in the edit or normal view. The least confusing way is to go to the slideshow tab on the ribbon and from the start slideshow section on the left, choose either from beginning or from current slide. I'm sure you don't want me to start over, so I'll choose the from current slide option and I'm back in the presentation mode. But there's a quicker way if you use the icons or even faster, a keyboard shortcut. Look on the top left and bottom right of the screen and you'll see icons that look like a projection screen. While the icons may look different depending on your version of Office, the one on the top means start or play from the beginning. Start with the first slide, usually your title slide if you have one. The one on the bottom means start from the slide you are currently on, in our case, our fourth slide. There are some keyboard shortcuts that will do the same thing, using the F5 function key. Just pressing F5 will start your presentation from the beginning, the first slide in the deck. Let me just hit Escape to get out of that. See, we're back to our first slide. I'll go to the fourth slide again. Now add the Shift key, so Shift F5, holding both keys down simultaneously, will start your presentation from the slide you are currently on. In our case, we're still on the fourth slide. When you are comfortable with the basics, you can practice with a few more keyboard shortcuts. These work when you are in the presentation mode, not the edit or normal view. And most of them are toggle commands, meaning you do something once to activate it and do the same thing again to inactivate it. I need to credit Camille Holden from Ethos 3 for her November 2018 blog, 5 PowerPoint Shortcuts Every Presenter Should Know. Let's start with hiding your screen by turning it white or black. Again, you are doing this while you are presenting in the slideshow view. Just press the W key, it doesn't matter if it's upper or lower case, and voila, a white screen. A comma will do the same thing. Press the W key or comma again, and you are back to your slideshow again. For a black screen, press B for black, and then B again to go back to your slideshow. Or if you prefer, a period does the same thing. Sometimes you may want to point to something. You can use your mouse or cursor to point, or you can create your own laser pointer by pressing down the Control key and clicking your mouse. As long as you hold both the Control key and your mouse buttons down together, you can drag your mouse around to act as a pointer. Do you want to draw, write, or highlight on your slide? Control P for pen will toggle the pen tool on, and Control P again will toggle it off. To highlight, think of ink, which starts with I. Control I will activate the highlighter tool, and Control I again will toggle it off. Now you have all these marks on your presentation slide. Control M will hide them. However, when you exit your presentation and go back to the edit mode, PowerPoint will ask you if you want to keep your marks or discard them. Now, if you want to go to a specific slide, you first have to know the slide number. Let me get out of this presentation mode for a moment. Now we're in the edit mode on the fifth slide. Let's go back into the presentation mode and dang, I accidentally started back at the beginning. But we were on slide 5, so all I have to do is type in the slide number, 5, then hit enter. Okay, I still have to go through all the animations again, but I got back here without having to go through every slide again. Some of you may be aware of the presenter view in PowerPoint, which works when you have two screens, like when you are presenting from a computer or laptop to a computer projection system. Presenter view allows you to see the slide that your audience sees, as well as any notes you may have on the notes portion of the edit or normal slide. It will also show you what the next slide is and tell you how long your presentation has been active, as well as the current time. And you can still use any of those laser pointer, drawing, and highlighting options. You use the F5 key again here, but this time you combine it with the Alt key, Alt F5. And again, Escape to get back to your edit mode. Well, I think we've covered quite a bit in a short period of time, like knowing the difference between the edit or normal view and the presentation mode or slideshow view, how to get in and out of presentation mode, and some pretty cool keyboard shortcuts you can use while you are presenting. Practice with these, and you'll be able to rock your next PowerPoint presentation, and maybe even amaze yourself.